From the beginning, this is the okay. SEM tabletop. Why call tabletop? Put on the top of the table. Tabletop. Okay, so this is a kind of SEM is with a very small and compact size if compared to the FESEM, full ignition SEM. So okay, we have the air and vacuum condition. Once we want to scan our sample, we must make sure it's in vacuum condition. So dalam tak ada air molecule, tak ada apa-apa, just vacuum. Once you want to change your sample, the tukar sample, just put the air mode, blend it, just press this button. So dia akan blinking. After dia stop blinking, baru you boleh open your door. So you just put your sample here. Okay, maybe dah boleh dekat sikit. So yang sample ni kan, ini sample stop. Okay, ada stop yang banyak lagi lah. Okay, so this one is the stop holder. The whole stop ni kat atas. So when we, after that, we just put your sample here. Ni ada satu bubak di sini. Sini ada satu cross kan, nampak tak? So cross tu kena gerak sampai dia kat tengah sini. Ini X knob, ini Y knob. X mean X direction, Y direction. Okay. Yang ni manual sikit lah, tak auto lah. Okay. Yeah, then demo system lah, yang auto motorized stage tu adalah optional lah. Kena extra budget sikit lah. So this one, you just pusing.
Nanti dia center kat.
Center kat groove ni, dia satu groove. Why we want to adjust this one? Because we want to make sure our sample kat tengah. Sebab detector dia kat atas. Backscatter detector kat atas. E, dia detector kat sini. Sebelah kiri. Okay. This one you just go move to the center. Ini sebelum you put in your sample kan?
Belum.
Okay, so means before you put your sample here, you just must make sure this is the safety height precaution here lah. The other sebab yang ni
maximum height ni.
Maybe 1 to 2 and gap between the this one. Why we got 2 here? Because this one is for imaging. This one is for the EDX. Sebab EDX tu kat EDX dia lebih rendah sikit. Boleh nampak dari sini. Ini detector dia. Atas backscatter detector. Yang ni EDX detector. Dia lebih rendah sikit. So that's why yang height ni juga rendah sikit daripada compared to the imaging. So you must make sure like bila you nak put in your sample, you nak imaging ke atau nak buat EDX? Kalau buat EDX yang ini lah.
Kalau
tak dulu? Aduh tu juga ini lah. Cuma same thing here, because this one is like lebih rendah kan. So detector kat sini kan. So working distance dia juga agak jauh sikit. So resolution a bit only lah, not much lah. A bit not a very good resolution. If you want have a good resolution, just take out imaging dulu, after that just taking again buat EDX. Ya itu buat satu-satu ya. Tapi kalau for the imaging kan dia sorry. Okay. Dia pun tak bad sangat lah kalau you using this one. Just like some kalau you memang tak puas hati dengan yang resolution ni, take out again and do this one adjustment, picking again and just mainly capture the image only. Sebab kalau for the EDX kan, resolution dia not really important lah. Okay. Because we want to do the elemental analysis, bukan nak tengok image dia baik atau tidak.
So, ni berapa detector?
Ada berapa detector?
Dua detector
saja. Satu backscatter detector and satu EDX. Okay. So this is the height adjustment lah.
So this one I want to
I ada banyak stuck kat sini lah. At least means at the same time kan banyak student nak scan kan. At the same time you boleh prepare the sample first, like, nak coating ke atau apa-apa, kita ada some specimen, some stuck here lah. Unless like okay. Yeah, ini pre-tube stuck. Pre-tube stuck like if you want to see the cross section of your sample, for example, so you can put your sample here, so you can see the cross section 90 degree. Sebab yang ini hanya kat atas saja. Just stationary, just can see the surface morphology here. I want to see it from the side, for example, so you maybe can stick your sample here. Or whatever, like, sebab dia ada banyak degree kan, 60 degree, so you just okay, put on this way. So just screw it like this one. So the other 45 degree like that. So if you want to do your EDA, sebab EDA kita dekat sini. Kalau surface you tak smooth, tak flat kan, ada tempat tinggi, rendah punya. So maybe I just suggest you, you face your sample towards the detector. Sebab detector kat sini kan, so you put your sample here, you can face your detector here. Kalau you just letak macam ni pun boleh. Cuma for example like tempat ini lebih rendah sikit, I want to dia akan block by the highest region here. So signal dia, dia akan block by the highest region, so tak boleh sampai detector. So mungkin your result got slightly different lah. For example yang sini memang tak ada gold, for example. Mengapa tiba-tiba ada gold? Sebab mungkin yang part ini ada gold, so dia detect the signal from the higher parts. Yeah. So if you want to save, you just face to the detector. Okay. So yeah, ini for the pre-tube start, you have a rotation unit here. Rotation unit is like you can rotate it 360 degree and you can tilt it. Same thing here, you can tilt it. So this one you can see more like a 3D effect. For example, so but yeah, ini just can see what on the top of the surface saja. So in this one, with this one you can see a slightly from the different angle, nak measure thickness dia ke, for example. Tapi sample dia tak boleh besar sangat lah. Kita biasa kena start mini saja. So kalau for sample ini, how to use start? Yeah. So this one is mainly for the some like electronic. I mean from the electronic research, we want to see the IC, integrated circuit. Dia dah see the bonding, dia ada bonding, ada banyak bonding. Want to see the gold bonding, so they will use the tilting stage. Now for sample, it is still okay lah. Just want to see the elemental analysis, surface morphology. This is just an additional unit. So once you want to use, you need to plug in this one. So biasanya kita just guna yang stationary ni, yang biasa punya. Atau you boleh guna pre-tube lah. Pre-tube dia juga ada tilting effect, just like. Tapi you tube ni memang degree ini saja lah. Yeah. So okay, it's in EDX. So this is the tabletop software. Few buttons only. Okay. Once you put in your sample, atau terus put in dulu lah. So okay, I just stick carbon tape. Sini I ada supply kau orang copper and carbon tape lah, so you must make sure kalau sample you carbon, tambah guna yang carbon tape lah. In case like you just nak imaging only is okay. Sebab you nak imaging only, you tak mau do the EDX. Yeah.
So this one just
because
I want to stick your sample.
But this one is very sticky. Once you remove your sample, it will have some carbon stick on the sample. Is it okay for you? Kalau for your, for example non-conductive specimen, you boleh guna carbon tape atau copper tape tu lekat kat sini and then lekat kat specimen, you ground it, groundkan dia. Bagi dah elektron ada tempat groundkan. This one is aluminium looking still okay. So just put it on the stock holder. Macam ni. Sebab yang ni tengok, sebab yang ni nak nampak EDS kan. Terlalu rendah kan. So you just unlock this screw here. Naikkan dia, ya.
Sampai dia kena ke?
Touch 1 to 2 mm gap. Roughly lah, roughly 1 to 2 mm macam tu. Miss the highest point lah, sebab yang surface ni tak flat sangat. Dia tinggi kat sini. So you choose the highest point to make sure the 1 to 2 gap, 1 to 2 mm gap macam tu. After that, just lock the screw here. Macam ni. Lock the screw. After that, you give
your
sample here. Use the Allen key to screw it here. Just screw kat sini. Tak apalah, yang ni ada satu screw saja. Use the Allen key to screw it. So dia takkan move lah yang holder you.
Ketakkan
dia. Ya, ketakkan dia. So yang ni ada another safety lah. Kalau sample terlalu tinggi kan, dia akan hit the wall here. Dia pun tak boleh tutup lah. Ya, this is another safety in case like you forgot to measure the height. Lupa to measure the height. Means once you close it, sample you yang rosak. Ya, sebab dia tak boleh close kan.
Rosak ni tak rosak.
Yang ini, I think this one quite hard lah, okay.
Yeah.
Okay, then just close it until dia tak satu tak. Yeah. After that, it's just
vacuum.
So, just sekarang sudah vacuum. Just try this one. Yeah, once you want to change your sample, tekan ni lagi. Ya, to go to air mode.
Oh, dia akan sendiri lah.
Ya, so dia akan sekarang dah selang blinking. Dia ada message box kat situ lah. Ini SEM, dia dua sekali.
Ada dua
SEM.
Ya. Just put in your sample, then you can choose this. You want to capture the image atau do the EDS. Choose the software only. $250 per sample. Kalau sample banyak kan, kita boleh bagi discount. And another option is like, kita ada offer like, you yang operate sendiri. So you can maybe the price is more cheaper lah. You operate sendiri. Maybe per hour per macam tu. Means like per hour maybe 600 to 800. But at the same time you can do many sample for example. So tengok your skill lah. Kalau you 1 hour boleh scan banyak sample, so you will berkat untung lah. Yeah. Okay, so this one So this is the UI, graphical user interface for the tabletop. There's few buttons only, fast mode, slow mode, reduce and freeze. This is the start button because the vacuum process is not really on, so cannot click the start button here. Okay, so here have some fast scan, like when you want to change the setting here, go to the fast scan. After you adjust everything, focus, brightness and magnification, you choose one, and then after you go to the slow scan. Nah, sini kan magnification kita boleh sampai 30,000 lah.
30,000, okay.
You just, this one, you just can simply drag it. Tengok, dia ada simbol sini kan. Drag it. Or unless you want to click one by one also can lah. Kalau sebab some people like, terus drag terlalu cepat. So they want to just slowly. Okay, we have some preset here. You can automatically go to the 1,000 or 100. We have some auto function here. Okay, we start here. auto brightness and contrast, auto focus. You just can simply click the auto brightness and contrast, but this is just a guideline for you. So some maybe someone a bright image or dark image is very subjective, depends. Yang ini sini boleh further adjust lah. Auto focus juga sama. Sometimes kita click auto focus dia tak really focus sangat. So you just can, this one can drag it. Tengok ada simbol ni tak, focus. Can drag it right or left. So once you want to focus it, go to the reduced mode. So you go to the higher magnification. I make it out of there, you just move left or right. You want to focus it. Tengok, sini become blur. Then you reverse back. Reverse back. Tengok, you cari some spot yang lebih senang tengok lah. For example, yang sini.
Oh, yang tu. Yang tu. Atas sikit. Kita nak dekat kan lah, jauh sikit. Ah, tu begini.
Yang mana? Yang sini.
Ah,
okay, sometimes it can double click it lah. Tapi yang ni sampai higher magnification baru boleh double click it, dia akan go to the center lah. Kalau kat low magnification kan, you double click it, dia akan show up the bola-bola acid 50 million. So you need to manually adjust it. Okay. So this is the sample, and this is the brightness and contrast autofocus. We have the some image mode here. Compo is the compositional information. Yang ni single click sajalah. Sebab kita yang ni tengok ada apa different tak. So sini lebih bright sikit, sini lebih dark sikit. Shadow one, shadow two, bright sini, dark sini. And compo mode like topography ke image. This one we adjust a single click. Depends on what kinds of information you want. Tapi biasanya kita
pergi
compositional information. Okay, this one is the rotation, but not the rotation of the star. This is the rotation for the detector. So this one like 90 degree, 180 degree, 270 degree like that. So this one go to the, for example this one, for example I want to focus on this one, but I feel like saying it macam tu, I tak suka. For example, you just can click one by one, and then dia akan move sikit sajalah. Sebab yang ni terus 90 degree, so maybe I want to move, bagi dia straight for example. I want dia bagi dia straight macam tu, for example. This one is like, this got another function and plus and minus here lah, minus is another way around. Okay, so this one just zero means go to the original position. Okay, here have some display function here. Date means tarikh yang kamu capture lah. Kalau you want to remove also can. Means kalau you sebab kat future kan, you nak guna balik image ni ke, atau if you include all the date here, so maybe 2 years after, like 2 years after, then you want to use back the same image kan? Then gambar ni 2013 punya, then sekarang already 2015 for example. So you if you want, no need to include the date also can. The time just like time sini ya. Plus plus distance, the working distance here, throughout the distance 8.1 working distance from the final lens. Magnification, they are show out here, copy times, image number. This one can simply put any title. Title sample, one sample A, sample B, ke polymer, ke composite. Ke. This one is the auto increment. Biasa kita start with 001. This one you save it, dia akan go to 002, 003, 4, 5, 6. So tak perlu, once you save it, kena rename again atau apa-apa. Dia auto, dia akan bagi you title, just insert a title here and 001. So after that, title ini 0033. Comment ya lah, you can write any comment you want. Ini with coating ke, without coating ke, you just write here. So you, at least you can identify, oh yang image ini, okay, comment ini without coating. Means yang sample ini without coating. This one you just can write any comment here. And we have some like so must be remember once you want to focus it, you go to the reduce mode. Dia akan lebih kecil sikit.
Tempat lain
boleh. I did now I just
explain the the function of the
okay. And we have some measurement function here. Once you want to measure, for example, I want to measure the length here, for example. Such as some other sample, yang other fiber, we have think of now. Measure the fiber thickness ke, diameter ke. Go to the freeze mode and go to the edit. Data measurement. So with the L symbol here, you just can just measure lah, whatever region you want to measure. Some other fiber, other thickness, other purple ke, yeah. Yang ada L with the L symbol, yang ni in inner diameter lah, ni outer lah. Tu for example, I want to measure here. Outer lah. So have take a shadow means a shadow effect here. Yang the rest one just like a
shadow tinta.
Yang ni tengok beza dia. Yeah, ni just like a
tukar colour dia punya
measurement
tu
dia punya tulisan
dia punya colour yang the rest ialah you boleh tulis any text here or whatever arrow okay yang ini komposi yang apa for example yang ni tapi yang ni without measurement lah just like you want to focus on something just like do some modification here and for example this one you want to focus it write something here, yeah. But with the L symbol here, you can move with the measurement. So if you want to clear it, either you clear all, then you clear. And then black color there. You need, you just clear it.
Delete.
Yeah, if you want measure like that, I want to clear one of the box, just like, think one of the other color there lah. Color merah, itu clear lah. Tapi once you save it, just the
yang ni same nanti akan ada macam label bawah tu juga.
Ada semua ada. Yang ni include kat dalam ni 002. Once you capture this image, you save it 001 and another is 002. Data yang sama, semua sama. Okay. Sini ada quick save dan save lah. Cuma resolutionnya beza sikit lah. Save resolutionnya sebab pixels value dia hanya 640 and time 480, so yang ni 1000 something pixels. Cuma memory ni yang ni file dia besar sikit dah. Ya kerana nak send through email kan lebih susah sikit dah sebab file terlalu besar. Okay, this is just example, okay? To show out the EDS first. So, for example, yang I nak buat EDS kat area ini. Because once you capture this, you want to do the EDS, right? So, EDS, you go to the image view here. Play the button here. So, dia akan import yang tadi punya capture punya image ke EDS. Just few button only, they are going to show up. This is image view, for your ID, like that. So this one, you can further adjust the brightness and contrast. Yeah, sebab bila kita import daripada tabletop kan, dia warna dia akan lari sikit lah. This one you can further adjust here, just right click macam tu. So just adjust the brightness and contrast. Okay. Now you can go to the point and ID. What means by point ID like? This is the point, this is the area analysis. Point means you just click point means, so they can come up with the spectrum. Area means like area the most good. For example, ni ada yang nak selo.
Ah, tu.
Eh, selo belum.
Surface mah.
Nanti I just delete lah. Sebab point kan dia hanya fokus kat satu point saja.
Kalau cara buat tekan Ctrl Z, undo tak
boleh. Tak boleh fokus.
Soalnya aluminium eh? Sodium ada, oksigen ada, kalsium ada.
Oksigen ada?
Tu ada.
Aluminium? Ada.
Ada atas. Klorin, yeah, klorin ada tangan kau tadi. Oh. Klorin.
Sebelum kita ada garam kan,
Tu sodium pun ada.
Betul lah. Garam.
Mana ada garam? Tak boleh habis dengan tangan.
So aluminium paling banyak lah.
Sebab your main element is aluminium lah.
68.
We will show out the weight percentage here lah.
Itu carbon, carbon
ada? Tip tadi ikut tadi. Carbon tu ada?
Carbon dia 12 something. Sebab tadi yang sample ada 4
kat inside kan. Asalnya kau punya tu ke poros kan? Lepas tu bila kau letak.
Memang tak takut dia daripada yang. Itu ada possibility juga. So this one all spectra, you can show off all the spectra in one diagram, so at least you can compare. Maksudnya boleh compare. So everything here, this one you just like export the word macam tu. So at least you can get your report lah. Tak perlu print screen ke, capture ke, guna kamera ke, yeah, this one is everything.
Gila tak sih?
So this one is summary, like summary for the spectrum one. Tadi all spectrum means spectrum 1, 2, 3. So after you save the spectrum one, again go to spectrum 2, save again lah. Kena buat satu-satu. So at that time you can choose which spectrum you want lah. Ni sampai kan pelik-pelik punya result. So you just Okay. And after that, we have the mapping. Mapping ialah show up the online scan tadi tu. Delete dulu. Mapping will show up the distribution of your element. Same thing, you click the play button, add element. Banyak aluminium kat sini. So dah tally with the point. Tengok tally point kat sini. Yang sample dia keluar kat sini. Yang ni banyak aluminium kat sini. Yang ni bukan aluminium. So we'll show out the distribution. Yang ni boleh color kan lah. Contrast biasanya RGB lah. Red and whatever is mix.
Can choose one.
Memang ada aluminium oxide ke atau aluminium. So, RGB lah biasanya. Nice.
Oh, distribution dia.
So, from this one, you can show out your sample is homogeneous or not. So, you can see that aluminium banyak kat sini. Means yang the white part kat sini, white region kat sini, tengok.
So carbon pun dekat surface juga lah.
Sikit sajalah. Sikit je.
Sodium tak ada.
Ada. Tak nampak sodium.
So yang ini kena take time sikit kan for mapping. Dia ambil masa sikit. Or you want to this means like some maybe you don't want to focus on oxygen or carbon kan, you just deselect
from two elements kan? Boleh,
you just deselect from the ya kan, hilang lah. For example, you want to focus on
maybe focus dekat
elemen yang dengan just deselect from the periodic table again. So you will show up, tengok banyak aluminium kat sini. Yang ni sangat okay lah.
Aku suka punya tadi pasal ni dah cukup lah. Dah cukup lah. Dah habis satu master.
Jadi combine sekali. Combine
apa? Combine color.
Boleh. Aku suka punya di Alpin ni, mak wifi tu.
Satu
kat
sini, RGB dia, you can compare. Red is aluminium, right? Just choose aluminium. Red is oxygen. So dia akan show ke sini lah. You want to show image-image yang capture tadi lah. Atau tak mau, just remove the image.
Oh, icon.
Okay, yeah, so ini show ini icon ini RGB. So you just select what color you want for which element here. After that, you boleh mix lah. Show image means the dia akan include image yang capture tadi. Atau you nak remove just lah. Color dia for this sample is very nice. Just some sample dia mix together off. Semua bertabung means whole surface ada minyak oksigen tu apa ada means not nice lah the image. Yang ni you can show here lah. This one is the aluminium, this one is oxygen.
Macam macam kita tahu sample kita homogenize ke tak?
Oh, okay, like this one kalau sample kamu kan. Kalau homogeneous means everywhere is the same element lah.
Oh.
Cuma kalau for mapping kan, kita prefer yang element yang different region. Lebih obvious, you can see that this one okay, this part have aluminium, this one is oxygen. Dia lebih cantik sikit lah. Kalau everything everywhere sama juga, so all the color mix together juga sama.
Tak
nampak apa-apa.
Jenis
mana ni? So yang ni juga sama,
sama
is just
distribution kadar dia sama.
So can show up all the color here.
Wah.
Yeah.
Dah. So satu paper lagi dah.
Like,
satu paper lagi dah.
Tu yang okay. Yang color lagi.
Tiga paper dah
lagi. Kat sini ada banyak color lagi tapi bukan RGB lah, maybe because buat magnesium tapi tak penting sama kan elemen ni tak mix together. Just choose any yellow ah or whatever.
So tadi kan kalau macam kalau kita touch sample kita ada klorin kat tangan kan. So kalau macam kita tak nak klorin tu kita boleh buang je kan.
Boleh buang boleh. Maybe pun you just double click kan. For example, I don't want the silicon. Just double click dah sudah disappear. Kalau biasanya add element dia akan everything lah.
So kalau kau tak pakai pun tak apa.
So kan ada weight friction kan. So the effect weight friction tak boleh buang apa.
Okay, yang tadi punya kan di sini. Percentage dia akan normalize to 100%. Dia akan normalize lagi.
Kita tak nak apa tu.
Kita tak nak
dia akan recover.
Oh, so kalau kita nak klorin so buang klorin lah.
Ya, klorin so tengok carbon oksigennya.
So kalau tak nak carbon cuba buang carbon tu.
So dia akan naik percentage dia.
Naik percentage.
Wow.
So dia akan normalize to 100% dia mesti.
So apa yang kita nak?
Okay. Yang itu kan like
macam
art defense sikit lah your result like
tak jujur lah.
It's not jujur lah. It's just like
bukan ubah maksudnya.
Tak berani cakap bukan.
Memang lah, sebab kalau you very confirm that your sample is tak ada chlorine for example. Sebab yang tak tadi guna tangan bukan. Just can but you must make sure that your sample ada element tu.
Yeah, betul.
Kalau you
tak tahu.
Kalau just buat apa-apa saja means the result is not clear lah.
Oh, yes. Yeah.
Sebab kalau you buat sample ini kan, you tahu you element ada kat dalam. Nampak aluminium, ada silicon, oksigen, itu for sure. You just choose this one, you just deselect all the rest element. Tiga saja. Sebab you very confident that your element memang ada
element
ini. Just deselect from the table. Double click ya kalau nak apa, just double click saja. So for the line scan also, mapping ni kena masak sikit lah. Cuma kalau for ini still okay lah. Dia boleh mix together. Yang ni dia
sekejap. Kalau mapping ni kita nak video guna mapping. Pada mapping punya color.
fingers show out the distributed value. You tak dapat apa-apa value ni.
Hmm.
The value only can get from the this one.
Hmm.
So same thing for the line scan also. Ini kalau delete dulu. So you go to line scan. Line scan maybe for example, these different faces. You just cross. Just go to play. You can show out here. So the aluminium sebab kat sini kan. So kat tengah-tengah ini, you just click whatever you want lah. You want to measure kan. Sini aluminiumnya sikit saja. So mainly is kat point ini juga lah. Silikon dia kat point ini.
Saja. Itu saja tujuh paper aku rasa.
So kat point ini memang
dah tak jadi alpia mau bye-bye terus.
Dia ada banyak silikon particle ini. Mean this one is like a different thing. It's just across the line you can show the intensity bagi setiap element. Jadi tapi yang ini juga graph saja dia tak show out the value. This one just an additional report for you. Additional report. Show means like you want to across some, maybe your sample is very flat. Tiba-tiba ada satu particle. Satu particle pun. Maybe you just across the particle. You show out, okay, yang particle ni ada apa element. So same thing here. Export to work. So everything work. So dapat graph. So this one is very easier for you to do the
report.
The mapping, other point in the ID. So this one is like very newest like.
iPhone.
Once you stop it, it only will stop. But then you can fix, you will boleh fix. Kena set the frame. Nah biasanya kita just do like continuous like. Agak-agak masa aja okay, dah cukup lah. So kita just stop it. Yeah, this one is only three function only lah. Just the mapping kan. Once you need to go to mapping, you need to delete all the light scan information. So this is the three function, point ID, mapping and the light scan. That's all.
Banyak result boleh dapat.
You can go to another region to find another spot and do the BTS again and export to work.
Dah habis dah ni. Tutup ni eh.